But the president, he says he is not going to jump up and down. He's not going to jump up and down and say people are going to die, even though people are dying. Americans are dying.
And it's always a serious problem. That doesn't mean I'm going to jump up and down in the air and start saying people are going to die, people are going to die. No, no, I'm not going to do that.
Not going to do that. He doesn't want to cause panic. Really? He's doing it again tonight. Trying to cause panic over, wait for it, Antifa moving in next door. Oh my gosh. Which, come on, let's be real here. That is not happening.
Does anybody want to have somebody from Antifa as a member and as a resident of your suburb? I don't think so too much. Say, darling, who moved in next door? Oh, it's a resident of Antifa. No, thank you. Let's get out of here. Let's get the hell out of here, darling. Let's leave our suburbs. Oh, I wish Trump were president.
So guess who I don't want next door? Someone who's going to put my neighbors and family and friends and me in jeopardy by refusing to wear a mask. Someone who's going to yell and scream at the local grocery store, hardware store, dry cleaners, pizza place that, you're taking away my right. I can't wear a mask. That's who I don't want in my neighborhood. That kind of selfish person who only is looking out for themselves and who don't believe in reality. The chances of that kind of person being next door to you, you have much more of a chance of that. Your odds are better than having someone from Antifa move next door to you. Let's be real. He expects you to believe that he doesn't want to cause panic. What was that? Do you really think someone from Antifa is going to move next door to you? Come on, really? That's what he's trying to do, cause panic in our cities, in our suburbs. Panic that he hopes will get him reelected. Doing it deliberately and cynically. Trying to scare, look at, oh my gosh, this is so scary. Trying to scare you, tweeting out a campaign video today full of looting and burning. Don Jr. tweeting one showing images of a pig's head on fire. And then there was one earlier this summer falsely suggesting that Joe Biden supports defunding the police. He does not. He said it over and over. The people who support defunding the police are ticked off at him because he doesn't support defunding the police. That's a lie. That he does not support it. But that doesn't stop the president from repeating the lie.